Hide your wife, guys. Hide your kids. He's coming for them.
Tomorrow, that's what I'm going to be doing, and that's really one of the few places you're going to see any kind of relief here in Southern California will be along the beach again. Tomorrow morning, you're going to wake up to mostly cloudy skies along the coast, but it should clear out fairly nicely.
It's currently Easter Sunday, so a lot of things are closed, so we're going to start the day out looking for food. I'm going to probably go to Subway. I do want to start out by saying thank you to everyone who's been supporting the new format of these vlogs with the episodes. Boy Meets Hype, people are loving it because me being on the bike, you get to see a lot more of Los Angeles rather than me just going from one place to another, not showing you the in-betweens of the city and the beauty of it. Yeah, let's go get some food and then go watch some NBA playoffs. I need this.
It's hard to vlog and bike at the same time. McGee,
get it, boy! So these are Kobe 8s that were produced in 2012. These are Kobe 8s that re-released as part of a special pack produced in 2015. This right here is Lunar Loin. Before Boost, this was the most comfortable thing on a sneaker ever. From running to basketball, made this, the Kobe 8, the best basketball shoe, in my opinion, of all time. So when they brought it back, I was really, really excited. To much disappointment, they gave us whatever the hell this is. To my knowledge, this is not Lunar Loin. There's no way these are both Lunar Loin. Like, this is way more squishier and comfortable. This is way more stiffer. Now, this one has Zoom Air in the back. This one doesn't. When this originally came out, certain models that came with Zoom Air and some didn't. They didn't give us the same technology they gave us when they originally brought the shoe, and that kind of pisses me off. Like, if I'm buying a shoe that I loved back in the day, which was just a few years ago, when it re-releases, I expect it to come out in the same exact form, you know what I'm saying? The good thing about it is that I can take this out of my old model and put it inside, hoping. Yep, it does fit perfectly. Obviously, it's the same shoe, same size. A lot of people don't even realize that it's not the same. The reason why I bring this up is just because I plan to play basketball in these, hopefully today. I'm gonna go to the gym, and it just sucks that it's not the same. We're paying more for this than we did this, so make it at least better or the same, you know?
Let's go play some basketball.
Beautiful, 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 beautiful. Oh, I missed you.
Alright guys, we at the gym now, so let's go ahead and put in this work, you feel me? Shout out to everybody still talking that smack in the comment section. We going hard, baby. The diet starts when? Tomorrow. Let's go!
See what they do. Kobe by Gasol trying to find Kobe. And Kobe will get it for the win!
What a good run, man. That was very, very fun. But now, we gotta go meet up with Ahmed at UCLA. He's up to something, and I guess while G's performing, he's in like a Backstreet Boys band or something, so we gotta go. UCLA is my old stomping grounds, you know what I'm saying? Alumni gang. You already know, class of 2040. What? Okay, so check this out. Ahmed doesn't have a beard anymore. Ahmed was growing out his beard for like 2-3 months or something like that. Wajib pranked him by shaving off a big chunk of his beard, pretty much forcing him to do a clean shave. And Ahmed, I guess, told his family that he's not coming to this. I don't know what he's up to, but he texted me and said, hey, I'm gonna be in disguise. Yeah, let's go see what Ahmed looks like without any facial hair, because I told him not to do a clean shave, but he did it anyway. Oh. I'm dead.
Yo, you can't show him my face yet. I haven't shown my face on anywhere. She had to put like a blurred thing.
I can't show him right now, but this fool looks like how he looks when I first met him. I can't, alright guys. Hide your wife, hide your kids.
Yeah. Let me see.
Is it wig good?
Oh my god, I'm dead, bro.
Love and marriage, love and marriage.
I swear this guy looks dead on my uncle, bruh. Here's the other dilemma, guys. I don't have a ticket to get in. Apparently it's sold out. So that's why I wore this hoodie right here that says staff. I'm hoping they just let me walk through the door because they think I work there. But this is actually a Bleacher Report Kicks hoodie that I got from SneakerCon New York. Shout out to Bleacher Report Kicks. I'm gonna say like I'm a cameraman for Bleacher Report or something. So I gotta sneak in. He's gotta go undercover. What if they don't even let you in? Like, I feel like they're gonna be like, well, sir, like you're way too creepy to go inside. Yeah, me and you can't even walk together, because then it'll be too noticeable. You gotta sneak on to UCLA. The disrespect, fam. I'm an alumni.
I know. Show up your ID.
Creepy ass guy behind me. This is the worst disguise ever. Everyone is literally looking at him like, who's the freaking creep off?
At me because he has a big ass camera.
God, guys, I'm getting a little emotional here. The Bruin Bear, man. Throwback to when we were trying to climb on top and I was the only one that could do it.
You're the only one that couldn't do it. Don't
stop,
freaking lie.
I think I could do it now. I think I could do it now. I'm trying to get in here. Hopefully we can get in. Let's try to sneak in.
Oh my god, he's so... What the hell? This guy came through.
Alright guys, I snuck in with Waji. I literally just walked in with him. I don't know how he found him, but he was literally just waiting at the door. Yeah, he has no idea that Ahmed's gonna be here, so that's why me and Ahmed have to split.
Staff boys, how you wore this so you can get in. I'm so surprised that this guy came. That means a lot, but you're gonna see a little culture, you're gonna see a little Bollywood, a little bit of boxing. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I might have to jump on stage.
Bring some... Love and hype.
Say no more.
Say no more.
Swag's watching playoffs.
Low key, this is more nerve wracking than Live in the Hype, because that is a skit. This is dancing on stage. That's a completely different ball game. If you miss a beat, if you mess up, you mess up. But in a skit, you can fix it.
Is it easy?
Like, go dancing. Make sure your dad
is in.
I'm done, baby.
So we're at Coachella right now. Coachella.
Guys, Coachella vibes 2017.
2017.
Drake's up right now. Drake's live right now. Wait, is it
so
DJ Khaled?
Lit. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, guys. For those of you that don't know what's going on or where I'm at, this is the PSA Culture Show.
Pakistani Student Association.
It's like all the universities around here.
What's up?
So basically, it's like UC Irvine, Riverside, UCLA, USC. And
San Diego, it's like Fullerton.
A big dance-off. They're going up next. We got food right now, intermission.
Yeah. You got the teacher, you are right.
How to feel be on stage.
Let's just say, man, it was dope. It was crazy. I'm happy that it's done. But what you think? Overall, what you think?
I saw you wink at me. It was good. It was good. I like the storyline. Yeah. Let's just say he had the drone shots.
Let's just say, learn from the Godfather. Papa Q.
Oh, I'm done.
Did you know?
Yeah, I knew. Did the Drake vocals come in yet?
Did the Drake vocals come in yet?
I'm not going to show the unveiling of when he surprised his family, but it was freaking hilarious.
You got it, right? You got everything.
I got everything. Yeah, I was wondering, I was like, cool. It's going to be on his channel if you guys want to watch it. It's the funniest. Bruh, I was dying. Waji's face was priceless, bruh. It was hella good.
They didn't know it. Like, they didn't recognize me at all. I came in like 2 times.
I'm dead, yeah. Oh my god. We're going to prank this guy right here.
I appreciate that, dog.
We got Ahmed. I knew it.
I knew my man Ahmed was gonna be here.
Do that move you did on stage, bro.
Yeah.
That was...
Yo, Wally, 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 Wally.
All sorry, bro. Right, I'm getting kicked out by this teacher right here, guys. Like, okay, I don't go to UCLA. I don't go to UCLA
Where's
anymore.
Your essays, Mr. Omar?
I don't go to UCLA anymore. Leave me alone. Guys, I'm actually joking about the whole UCLA alumni. I just made that up. So for those of you guys that don't know, I am a global brand ambassador for Crep Protect, the best sneaker cleaner in the game right now. And if you don't believe me, ask a very reliable source, Complex. Yeah, they did a whole video about this recently. And Crep Protect was voted by their office as the number one sneaker cleaner in the game. As being a global brand ambassador, I do get tons of product to always, you know, just have at my house. We've never done a giveaway for Crep Protect. I've never done a giveaway for Crep Protect. So I thought, you know what? I get a lot of people who tweet me and ask me for free Crep Protect. So I was like, you know what? Let's have our first of many giveaways. I'm gonna give one away of each product. First off, we got the Crep Protect Cure. Next up, we got the Crep Protect Wipes. Next up, we've just got a regular bottle of Cure in case this runs out, you get another bottle. The Crep Protect Rain and Stain Repellent. The newest product to the Crep Protect lineup is the Crep Protect pill, one pill per shoe to make your shoes smell clean and fresh, and it kills back, it kills, I can't read this. Now, you're probably wondering, hey, Kais, where are you gonna do the giveaway? The giveaway will be done on my Instagram. I am almost at 400,000, wait, is it 500,000 or 400,000? 400,000, we're a long way from 500,000. We're almost at 400,000 followers on Instagram. When we reach When we reach 400,000 followers on Instagram, then I will post a picture with the giveaway. So don't tweet me, don't comment on my Instagram, don't DM me, don't email me, don't do any of that yet, because that's not how you're gonna win. How you are going to win, only through that one Instagram post that I post when we reach 400,000 followers on Instagram. Maybe I'll do like a first, second, and third place because I have a ton of product, and I'll select the winners at random, and an explanation of how you can win the contest will obviously be on that post, all right? I was gonna just end the vlog there, but we have to end the vlog on this note. This morning when I woke up, I woke up to a few tweets of people sending me screenshots from Casey Neistat's vlog.
This is my first in-flight meetup.
This kid right here is wearing the Dream Crew Space Jam hat. This kid, if you're watching this, you are a legend. You are the GOAT. If I ever meet this kid, and I will meet this kid, I don't know if I have or I will, if I meet this kid, I'm gonna give this guy a huge hug because he's repping, not just because it's in Casey's vlog, but because he's repping the crew. It's still unbelievable to me that people want to represent something that I represent, man. And for you guys to wear a shirt or a hat or a sweater or whatever it is and rep Dream Crew in your everyday life, blessing to me. And the fact that it's being represented on a video that has 2 million views is just amazing. So shout out to that guy, shout out to everyone else who's ever picked up merch from me, and for everybody else in the future that's gonna pick up merch from me and rep it hard, because the Dream Crew is about living your dream, chasing your dreams, accomplishing your dreams, and turning them into a reality. And for your next opportunity to pick up some merch, you know I'm gonna do a shameless plug, SneakerCon Bay Area. Oh yeah, it's coming.